Linguists who do field work are very often called upon to analyze the spatial coordinate system used by the speakers of the languages they work on. Usually they start off with an assumption that this system, however different it might be from a European system, must be consistent, must be logical. I want to challenge that assumption, but actually based on my own experience as a speaker of English, making use of the cardinal directions north, south, east, west. But if you put me down in a strange city, I've never been to Sofia, Bulgaria before, give me a map, give me directions, left, right, east, west, and so on, I'd be able to find my way around in general. I'd turn the map around and I'd still be able to make the relevant accommodations. It was therefore a surprise to me when, in my early 30s, did actually move west, so from my home in England to California, initially to Los Angeles. I would be driving on the freeway and I'd come to signs like this, very clearly telling me which way is east and which way is west, and I would consistently go the wrong way. I would think something was in the east when in fact it was in the west. Why? To answer that, I think you have to go back to my home area. This is my hometown, Sunderland, on the coast of the North Sea in England. Here, you see a blown-up version of that same area. Notice the coast is very much a north-south flowing coast. The sea is in the east. Most of my childhood was spent within a couple of miles of the sea. What happened was that I developed an auxiliary model of the cardinal directions, where east meant towards the sea. You always knew where the sea was. This is England. Navigating by the sun is not a good survival strategy. When I moved to Los Angeles, the problem was someone had moved the sea. It was at the other side. I thought it was at the east. In fact, it was at the west. I look at a map, I know that perfectly, put me on the freeway, and my model, the model which worked in my home area, hijacked what I know to be the truth, took over as the model by which I actually operated. If I'm far away from the sea, these are other places that I lived around the same time, Germany, interior England, Russia, there I didn't have any problem. There's no sea, so the auxiliary model doesn't hijack my basic understanding. Two final comments. I'm in good company. Here you see Dustin Hoffman as the graduate, driving from San Francisco to Berkeley, totally unaware that the top level of the Bay Bridge actually carries the westbound traffic. And in case you were worrying whether I would successfully make it to the west or not, I did. That's me there.